Bull Terrier was originally developed in the 19th century as a fighting dog. The breed was later reimagined as a fashionable companion for gentlemen. The reimagined Bull Terrier first appeared in his present form at the Birmingham show in 1862. The breed was shown by James Hinks. He was a dog dealer who was generally accepted as the original breeder of today's, of the modern Bull Terrier. Hinks used many different breeds and types of dogs in the creation of what he considered to be a gentleman's companion. Hinks' version of the Bull Terrier is likely to consist of Bulldog, English White Terrier, which is now extinct, and Dalmatian. His preference was for a white animal, and it seems that the dog fanciers of the time were in agreement. His breed quickly gained popularity and was successful at early dog shows, which were rapidly becoming popular at the time. After several attempts, the Bull Terrier Club was formed in 1887. At this time, the breed consisted mainly of white specimens, the color generally being of a different type. Shortly after the 20th century commenced, determined and successful efforts were made to breed colored Bull Terriers. Today, the colored and white are one breed. Through rigorous selective breeding, the Bull Terrier today has developed into a companion animal and much-loved family pet. This breed is extremely affectionate with people and is particularly noted for fondness towards young children. Nevertheless, this is a strong breed, very powerful animal, and should always be remembered that he is at first and foremost a terrier with a competitive spirit and may not always be tolerant of other animals. The height of the breed is 21 to 22 inches at the withers. The weight should be roughly 50 to 70 pounds. A life expectancy of the breed is 12 to 13 years. Bull Terriers are considered to be trainable, stubborn, keen, sweet-tempered, active, and very protective. All right, guys, so as far as my recommendation goes, many of you guys know that I'm into larger breeds, 100 pounds or plus, but I do like, for the most part, and respect all working animals. The Bull Terrier is, at this point in time in history, more of a companion animal, especially if you're talking about getting them from a show breeder. There are some programs out there, however, where I have seen working Bull Terriers. I don't have a lot of familiarity with them, but I do know that I've seen videos of them working, and they seem to be great working dogs. They do pretty much what any other catch animal would do, dealing with prey. Don't want to get too much into that. I know how that concept of animals hunting other animals offends people, so I'm going to move on. As far as family companion goes, I think a Bull Terrier is just as good as any other dog. They have a solid temperament. They are very loving, not a lot of insecurities in the breed. Some have been known to deal with separation anxiety. I don't know how you deal with that, but I've known that to be a hit or miss thing. I don't necessarily know that it is a breed thing. It may just be something that I've come across in the few Bull Terriers that I've met, and I can only think of maybe of two that I know of that had some issues with separation anxiety. But for the most part, this breed is a hardy, sturdy, mentally well-balanced breed. If you're looking to get one, I would say do your research. Obviously, there are some health issues that do affect the breed. Again, the best way to avoid any health issues with any breed is through proper breeding, health, and nutrition. So you want to find yourself a breeder who's doing all the screening for appropriate diseases. And then once you get your dog, you want to make sure you keep them healthy, keep them at a healthy weight, give them the appropriate amount and the appropriate type of exercise, and you feed them the best food possible. If you're looking for a Bull Terrier, make the move. These dogs add amazing value to your life. They're great companions. They're fun dogs. They're funny dogs. They're loving dogs. In terms of grooming, there's not a lot of grooming to deal with. There's not a lot of shedding. So I'm a big fan of the Bull Terrier. They do provide a certain level of protection and guarding ability. They are aware and they are confident, so they will stand their ground. They will bark. They will make notice of intruders. So those are good things.